determination of the molecular weight of an unknown acid. This is the apparatus we will be using for this lab. The burette, pipette, pipette bulb, and burette clamp can be found along the side bench. Everything else can be found in your drawer. All chemicals needed for this lab can be found either in the TA fume hood or by the top loading balances. Remember to take note of the concentration of sodium hydroxide provided in your lab. There are two main components to this lab: making a standard solution of unknown acid and titrating the standard solution against a sodium hydroxide solution of known concentration. First, in order to prepare the standard solution, weigh by difference the appropriate amount of unknown acid as indicated on the acid bottle. Remember to tear the top loading balance before adding any acid to the weighing bottle. Once you've weighed out the appropriate amount of unknown acid, you're ready to move to the analytical balances. Please remember to cap the bottle of the unknown acid before leaving the side bench. This is the equipment you will need to bring with you to the analytical balance room. You may use a short stem funnel if the powder funnel in your drawer does not fit your volumetric flask. In the analytical balance room, place the volumetric flask, funnel, and wash bottle on the counter opposite to the analytical balances. Before using the analytical balance, ensure that all doors of the balance are closed and the balance reads 0.000 grams when empty. You may tear the balance if necessary. Carefully place your weighing bottle with the lid on inside and close the doors. Allow the reading to stabilize before recording it in your lab notebook. And remember to record the weight to 4 decimal places. Next, using a Kim wipe, which can be found by the balances, carefully remove the weighing bottle. It is important to avoid direct contact with the weighing bottle at this point to prevent the transfer of any oils from your hand onto the bottle. Transfer the unknown acid into the volumetric flask. You may notice that not all of the powder will transfer into the flask, and this is okay. The important thing is that you know exactly how much acid you have transferred into the volumetric flask. Carefully replace the lid of the weighing bottle before returning to the analytical balance. Place the empty bottle back in the same balance and record the mass of the empty bottle. At the opposite bench, wash down any powder adhering to the funnel with distilled water and bring everything back to your bench. In your lab notebook, calculate the mass of the acid transferred into the volumetric flask by taking the mass of the bottle plus acid and subtracting the mass of the empty bottle from it. You will use this mass to calculate the concentration of your standard solution. To finish preparing the standard solution, add about a third of the flask volume using the wash bottle and rinse the neck of the flask while doing so. Swirl the flask to allow the acid to dissolve. It is important to dissolve all the solid before filling to the mark. Do not invert the flask at this step. Once all the solid is dissolved, fill the flask to the mark. You should use a wash bottle to add water until the bottom of the neck and then use a disposable pipette to carefully fill to the mark. Remember to be extra careful at this step. If you go over the mark, you will need to begin all over again. The bottom of the meniscus should sit on the mark. Stopper the flask and invert 15 to 20 times to ensure thorough mixing of the acid throughout your standard solution. Next, prepare the burette for titration by rinsing and filling it with sodium hydroxide solution provided in the TA fume hood. For a more detailed explanation of how to set up the burette and pipetting and titration techniques, please watch the video in the description below. Pipette 3 25 milliliters of your standard solution into 3 labeled Erlenmeyer flasks. Add 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator into each flask. Place the first flask under the burette and take the initial reading before beginning the titration. All readings from the burette should be recorded to 2 decimal places. In this experiment, the expected endpoint is a very pale pink color that persists for at least 30 seconds. The color of the endpoint should be pale such that it is not perceivable from a distance. As you add more sodium hydroxide beyond the endpoint, the solution will become more magenta. Here, the flask on the far left is before the endpoint, the second flask shows a good endpoint, and the flask on the far right represents a poor endpoint. You should aim to achieve the palest pink color possible. Once you have reached the endpoint, read the final volume from the burette and record it in your lab notebook. In your notebook, subtract the initial volume from the final volume to calculate the amount of sodium hydroxide solution needed for the titration. Repeat this process for the remaining two flasks and calculate the average for the three trials.